Welcome to today's edition of the Rush 24/7 podcast.
Let us go to Joe Concha from The Hill, because Joe has an excellent column today called Media Must Set Higher Standards for Reporting Career-Ending Accusations. And Joe, right now they don't seem to have any standards at all, really.
I mean, I don't know if you're surprised, Mark, anymore by the way our media conducts itself with basically every political story. And I'm not talking about local media. I still think that's pretty good when I get my local news and I get my sports and I get my weather and I hear about who robbed this or who ran over this person or whatever. I'm keeping them out of it, and I'm keeping international reporting out of it as well, because I still think that's pretty strong as far as what goes on from war zones. The problem is we never see that kind of reporting anymore in the U.S. It's all Trump all the time, because that's what rates. But in this case with Kavanaugh, I mean, have you ever seen the media take one side as much as they have, and it's all under the premise of you are guilty until proven innocent, Brett Kavanaugh? Yeah. That is the theme that they're going with.
And you make the point here that the media can't be as stupid as they appear to be, because you bring up, for example, someone who purported to be an old school friend of the accuser, who was at the same school and who appeared to confirm the story. And then it turned out, no, she didn't actually know her at all. That, in fact, she has no connection to the accuser. No.
Right. It's called vetting, right, in journalism, where if somebody just says, yeah, I know that this happened between Brett Kavanaugh and Catherine Ford, and she puts it up on her Facebook page, and then suddenly the thing goes viral instantly.
Right.
But then it's discovered not too long after that, by her own admission, that she doesn't know Catherine Ford, that she doesn't know whether it happened, and she just kind of simply opposes Brett Kavanaugh because he's a Trump Supreme Court nominee. And
right.
This was a story for hours. And the problem is, a lie can go a billion times around the world through social media before the truth ever gets its pants on. So even when they finally correct, you know, in some subsequent tweet or a clarification, the lie is already out there.
Yeah,
and that's the whole problem. So that was one example that I found. I couldn't believe that even got to air in the first place.
Well, what is the issue here? Because I, as I said, I can't believe that these reporters are that stupid. So therefore, in a sense, there's a lack of good faith in how they're covering the story, isn't there?
You're exactly right about that. When I hear from other reporters that say, well, we're human, we make mistakes, so, you know, mistakes are going to happen once in a while. Yeah, of course they are. That's fine. But these aren't dumb people like you talk about. These are shrewd people. They're calculating. Again, I don't want to use a broad brush. This isn't all media members, and this isn't all of one network. You know, there's still some good people out there. But the problem is that it is so intentional and it's so transparent what is going on here, right? I mean, for instance, Jim Sciutto, right, who worked in the Obama State Department. He's a smart guy, and he worked for ABC before that. Now he's an anchor at CNN. He actually had a story yesterday or a tweet yesterday where he said that Chuck Grassley, who runs the Senate Judiciary Committee, he's the chairman, had only offered Catherine Ford the option to testify in Washington in front of the Senate with all the cameras rolling. And it was blatantly untrue, because Grassley's office even had to respond to the tweet, saying, no, we offered her the ability to testify in private in Washington, or we'll even go out to California and
talk
to her at her home or wherever. And Sciutto had to have known this. So Grassley's office responds, you know how long it took Sciutto to then send out a correction tweet to say, oh, yeah, there are other options? 20 hours.
Right,
in a social
media
age, that should take 20 minutes, Mark.
No. And people,
the first tweet got retweeted 7,600 times, and then Sciutto's correction tweet, like something like 90. So again, the lie got out there, and when the correction came, no one cared anymore because the lie was too juicy if you're anti-Trump.
Yeah, and it's a bit like a lot of this stuff is like Chinese whispers, if you can still use that expression, because you quote a guy in here saying that basically damning Brett Kavanaugh because his fraternity at Yale, he posted a picture of Kavanaugh's fraternity at Yale waving a flag woven from women's underwear. There's no Kavanaugh isn't in the picture. These are a bunch of guys who we don't even know whether he's ever met any of these guys who are waving the underwear flag around. But let's take the underwear flag and hang it round Kavanaugh's neck. I mean, that's not even guilt by association. That's guilt by association with somebody's novelty flag made from ladies' underwear. I mean, I don't even get that.
And the best part is that the Insider Reporter, this is the Washington bureau chief for the Washington Post. Okay, yeah. This is a very big deal.
Right.
And he tweets that out, and so then when people start calling him on it, like, wait a minute, Kavanaugh's not even in the picture.
Yeah.
What's your point? He says, oh, well, if I wasn't clear in my first tweet, I was trying to say that this was reflective of the culture of the fraternity that Brett Kavanaugh belonged to. I don't know, Mark, if you've ever seen Animal House.
No, I know.
Nerds.
Yeah, no.
I was in a fraternity.
Right.
I'm telling you, that's very benign compared to some other rituals that go on at frat houses across the country. So to say it's reflective of the culture of Kavanaugh's fraternity, and that's, again, that's somehow a story? Come on. And if this were a Democrat, if this were Merrick Garland, Mark, could you see any of this stuff happening? Of course not.
No. You're absolutely right. It's reflective of the culture. Yeah. Try taking that to a county courthouse and getting it in under the rules of evidence. It's a great piece, Joe, and our listeners can read it in the Hill.